A man died the other day. In Memphis, Tennessee. Nonviolence was his philosophy. He loved all men and feared his God above. His philosophy of nonviolence was a philosophy of love. He was a man with a colored face, but did not think this was a disgrace. Yes, as gentle as a lamb, and like a lion, he was bold. Though his face may have been black, but he had a heart of gold. Like Paul and Silas, he went to jail. That man might be free, he paid a mighty bail. Beaten, rebuked, and often scorned, he bore his racial cross and wore his crown of racial thorns. And he sought to overthrow the mountain of hate, to let the world know slavery was out of date. Then you could tell that he was a Christ-touched man. And this was the secret of his non-violent stand. Non-violence, he said, though they strike you down. On his knees, reaching up, though to get his crown. As our Lord said to Peter, Peter, put up your sword. For he that lives by will also die by the sword. These words were echoed by Dr. King in his own way in our times. Stop the war. Stop the bombs. And my brothers, stop the crime. Nonviolence, he said, to angry young men. Let's give them love for their terrible sin. And though this young Moses, Martin Luther King's voice is now still, there'll be a Joshua and there'll be a Caleb somewhere saying nonviolence still. Though he is named and numbered with the dead, the whole world heard him and nonviolence, that's what he said. That he loved his way to heaven, and we cannot bring him back. But let's love our way to a united America and make her dream of freedom and nonviolence a true and a living fact.